For me, the polyphony is very important in poetry. I think that is a reason per se of writing poetry as opposed to prose or anything else. Min bror sa, jag vill veta vem som förnedrades för min skull. Min far sa, kroppar utan klarhet, kroppar utan skugga. The possibility of sort of creating plurality of voices and different layers, you know, like a choir. I think about the book almost like a choir, you know, with all these different versions sort of the same narrative, you know, going on in parallel.
Mein Vater sagt, es gibt einen Krieg, der sich in den Eingeweiden abspielt. Es gibt einen Feind, der aus meinen Händen und aus meinen Lippen stürzt. Meine Mutter sagte, wenn wir nach Können geben und nach Bedarf bekommen. Mein Bruder sagte, wenn Unrecht und die Geschichte selbst enden.
You teach poetry. Is poetry something you can teach?
Yeah. Yes. Yes, I'm a firm believer of that. Actually, I think everything can be taught. I don't believe in sort of mystifying art. I mean, of course, you have to work hard and you have to sort of have be in touch with certain things in life and language in order to be able to write well. But I believe that people can learn how to write poetry. Yes.
Min mor sa, när vi ger efter förmåga och får efter behov. Min bror sa, när alla orättvisor och historien själv tar slut. Min mormor sa, när du är lika gammal som jag, då ska alla orättvisor och historien själv ta slut.
When we published this anthology, we were interested in queerness as a matter of, you know, accounts of gender, sexuality, etc. But also as a matter of form, you know, is there queerness in form? And what could that be? So I don't think, you know, queer is one specific thing that you can narrow down, but I think it is a take maybe on form.